गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम टू थिंका इस चैनल। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द एंथ्रोपोलॉजी। अवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट फॉर्म्स ऑफ नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन आर यूज्ड इन ह्यूमन सोसाइटीज। ह्यूमन एवरीवेयर कम्युनिकेट नॉन वर्बली एज वेल एज वर्बली। इन एवरी सोसाइटी पीपल यूज जेस्चर्स, फेशियल एक्सप्रेशन, पोस्चर एंड टाइम टू कम्युनिकेट विद वन अनदर। However, the meaning of a gesture or expression may vary greatly from culture to culture. Next question is, describe two key ways in which language changes. Both the sound and the vocabulary of languages change over time. For example, many sounds of medieval English do not exist in current English. New words enter vocabulary through innovation as well as contact between cultures. Vocabularies reflect histories, frequently including conquest and submission. Was there ever a single human language? The question is, was there ever a single human language? Linguists have developed techniques to trace the histories of languages and relationship among them. However, these techniques cannot determine if there was ever a single human language. The development of language involved genetic changes, and these are likely to happen in a single small group. Hence, there probably was a single original language. Was there ever a single human language? Linguists have developed techniques to trace the histories of language and relationship among them. However, these techniques cannot determine if there were ever a single human language. The development of language involved genetic changes, and these are likely to happen in a single small group. Hence, there probably was a single original language. Next question is, are we moving toward a world with only a single language? Are we moving toward a world with only a single language? Linguistic diversity has decreased dramatically, and languages face the threat of extinction. However, many languages have millions of speakers and are unlikely to disappear. As languages expand to include more speakers, the diversity within them may increase. People who speak the same language may not understand one another. Next question is, what is the relationship between the environment and subsistence food getting pattern of a society? Different physical environments present different problems, opportunities, and limitations to human population. The subsistence pattern of a society develops in response to seasonal variation in the environment and environmental variations such as drought, flood, and animal diseases, as well as cultural factors. As population have increased and more complex forms of social and economic organization have developed, humans have had increasingly intensive impacts on their environments. Next question. What are the major subsistence strategies of human populations? The five major subsistence patterns of human population are foraging, F-O-R-A-G-I-N-G, foraging, that is fishing, hunting and gathering, pastoralism, horticulture, agriculture and industrialization or industrialism. As a whole, humankind has moved in the direction of using more complex technology, increasing its numbers, and developing more complex socio-cultural systems. Next question is, what is foraging? How has the Inuit foraging strategy have been affected by global warming? What is foraging? How has the Inuit, I-N-U-I-T, Inuit foraging strategy have been affected by global warming? Foraging is reliance on food neutrality available in the environment, acquired through hunting, fishing, and gathering. It was the major food getting pattern during almost all of the time humans have been on Earth. Although this way of the life is rapidly disappearing, foraging is still a useful adjunct to other subsistence strategies for many societies. With the gradual decrease in the Arctic ice, many Inuit have had to change the timing and focus of their foraging strategy and seek alternative ways of food getting. Changes in the subsistence strategies are like to have a profound impact on Inuit culture. What is foraging? How has the Inuit foraging strategy been affected by global warming? Foraging is reliance on food naturally available in the environment and acquired through hunting, fishing, and gathering. It was the major food getting pattern during almost all of the time humans have been on Earth. Although this way of life is rapidly disappearing, foraging is still a useful adjunct to other subsistence strategy for many societies. With the gradual decrease in Arctic ice, many Inuit have had to change the timing and focus of their foraging strategy and seek alternative ways of getting food. Changes in the subsistence strategies are likely to have a profound impact on Inuit culture. Next question. What are the different kinds of pastoralism? How is pastoralism affected by the inclusion in state societies and the global economy? Pastoralists rely on herd animals. Nomadic pastoralists move with their herds. Transhuman pastoralists establish permanent villages and part of the population moves with the herds. Because animals cannot provide an adequate human diet, supplementary food such as grains are required. Therefore, pastoralists cultivate crops or develop trading relations with the food cultivators. In state societies, pastoralists are often under pressure to conform to state goals that often aim at moving them into agriculture. At the same time, the global economy provides market for the animal products. Thank you very much.